Okay, so I will talk about the electrophilic bath method. Okay, so what is that? We'll go along and then talk about that. Okay, so we have overwhelming evidence from cosmology, astrophysics, something which is produced gravitational attractiveness, but then you don't see it. Okay, so if you, from all these different observations, and also if you believe the Big Bang theory, then you'll find about 26 of them of the energy particles in the universe is a explain it, why, what this might be the origin. There are a lot of different things. So, but then we don't really know what this dark matter might be. But then we have some general sort of understanding. So, it produces gravitational attraction. That's how the large structure formation goes out. And then, since it doesn't, you don't observe it by electromagnetism, and then this is seen as being a neutral, and then should be very weakly impacting, because brilliant cluster, sort of the data shows that. But now, of course, yesterday I also heard that there may be some self-impaction. Well, it should be non-limit. If it decays, it should be 10 to the, what, about 3 seconds, much longer than the age of the universe. Well, maybe then you just make it stable by some sort of circuitry. And it could be hot, warm, and cold, depends on how you have the fraction, or depends on what sort of percentage of each of them. And there, but then the cold much better, since arguably the best scenario people are talking about. Also, we don't know exactly what is the mass or what is the spin of this particle. So you have a lot of imaginations, and then a lot of things you can do. Writing papers is one of the things. Provide your own idea to see what can explain experiment the data. But now, of course, all these things, et cetera, we don't see any of them in a standard model. Okay? Although sometimes people come up with some sort of bound state of exotic or hot state, may be able to explain, but then these ideas are floating around and then disappear. So most of them, believe that the dark matter has to be beyond the standard model. Well, even beyond the standard model, there are a lot of possibilities. One of the most studied is the weakly interacting massive particle. And then that's not all of them. You might have some axion, which is different than this massive weakly interacting particle, maybe some other particles. Okay. So, but now of course I will not talk about all the possibilities. I will talk about this wind type of dark matter. But then, even within this, how the wind particle interact with standard model particles, how you produce signals, still have a lot of things you can do. But now, of course, you have many of them probably have seen this diagram. So you have dark matter, and then in the early universe, you want to produce the correct radiant density, about 26%. And then there's a dark matter analysis, and then during the course, out of equilibrium, and then you have some standard model analysis, and then finally you're left with the correct density. Okay. Also, you can produce dark matter maybe through this type of standard model of particle collision. And then produce dark matter, for example, LHC, lab, and the future ones, IOC, CEPC, click, all type of things you can talk about, and then you can produce it. And of course, then you can also say, well, maybe in our galaxy, dark dark matter halo or here, they dark matter with each other and they decide to say, oh, let's go to the standard model or sector. So then, in, what people most talk about the indirect sort of detection of dark matter this way. And of course, you can also so this type of dark matter come in and then scatter of the standard model particle and scatter out. Then this is like how you directly detect dark matter. Okay. So what is the situation now? Well, this is how you produce the radiant density, and then if you follow the thermal or equilibrium, and then it drop very quickly. But it's sometimes you drop out of equilibrium, and you go stay here or stay here, stay here, depending on your model parameters. Of course, when we want this 26%, and it must be somewhere here, on this side. Okay. So once you've done that, then you have pretty much how your parameters to produce the dark matter. If you assume just one type of dark matter, then this will fix up some of the interaction and strength. And then directed detection, now we have a lot of experiments trying to detect it. Mostly is parallel using nuclei as a target. Okay, like a xenon detector, and some other things. But so this is how the dark matter hit the nuclei and then get the recoil energy. Then in your detector, you get some signal. But then this has been put a very stringent bound. And then now it's somewhere here. And future experiment, maybe lower down, lower down, lower down. And then at some stage, it will hit the neutrino background. So, the Earth and the Sun neutrinos. So, and then once you get down here, it will be very difficult to experimentally detect the dark matter. But then, of course, you know, our experimental colleagues are very smart. When you have difficulties, they will solve it when time comes. But then, right now, people think it's very difficult. So, the thing is, here, we haven't had to see dark matter. Many of them is scattering of the nuclei, okay? But then, of course, there are some claims in the literature at a lower mass range, there are some data shows some, for example, this is collagens and some other CDMS that before shows something. And then also there's a famous gamma data always stick around here. No one else believed it, but then if you talk to them, then of course, if you want to get out of the room, if you don't say, maybe I'm convinced that you want to get out of the room. They are really thinking they have seen something. But then last week, actually, there's a Nature paper, a science paper says similarly in this region, also low mass being ruled out. But then, other experimental observations already rule out this. So so by looking at dark matter scatter for nuclei, we don't see any dark matter. Okay. So but then the dark matter might be there. So if the dark matter indeed are wave type, maybe they don't scatter with nuclei. Maybe they scatter with electrons. And then in that case, so this thing that you are not looking at the dark matter, but you cannot see. So, but then so people have to think about how if all this dark matter is a spectrum of the electron in the atom, and then you can say, well maybe even this dark matter impacted the leptons also detected. Okay, but then if you heat the electron, the recoil energy is proportional to the targeted mass. So if you hit the electron, hit the nuclei, it's about 2,000 times smaller in the cross section. So that makes it very much more difficult. Okay, but then this possibility maybe explain why you don't see dark matter now, and then later on if you do this. Dark matter interaction with the electron, precise enough, maybe you will see that. Okay? So, if some dark matter which only interact with the standard of leptoparticles, and then this is what I indicated at the title macrophilic dark matter. So that means that this dark matter mainly interact with electrons. Okay? So this sensor for the okay, if you don't have another sort of a test, then you might not really see whether this is good. Also, I also say direct detection. This is an LHC, not it's a beam. Okay? Collision with given the waves. You have a mono jazz or whatever, or jazz, a photon jazz, or ground jazz. You don't see it. Okay? Again, then under the LHC, this is a proton collide with a proton. Of course, if it's a electrophilic, you can't produce it at all. Right? So you don't see the signal. Okay? So this is also can argue for electrophilic. But now, what about the indirect detection? Okay, so 10 years ago, about 10 years ago, there's some Hamela results. It says, they see in our galaxy, some satellites in the space, they try to detect the electrons and the positrons. Okay, so in that case, what people expect some flaps under the electron, positron, and this is the energy. They expect to see something like this, okay? But the Hamela sensor showed the result going up. So then it seems to be way different than expectation. Okay? So then the people think, well, maybe this is due to dark matter, okay? So a lot of people jump into this trying to explain this by look at what type of dark matter model make experiments. Okay, but then this is impacted. So if it's due to the dark matter, this is the electron. So that's maybe the dark matter has something to do with the electron. And then that fits in what I call it the electrophilic dark matter, maybe quite well in the sense interaction with the electron. Well, there are many other observations also say this is the primary. You can also get the electron positron together to look at the flux. And then this is the primary data, just some excess. And then all several others also seems to see at a high energy also show this type of excess. Okay, so then people continue writing papers to explain all these things. So this has a more sort of data, more precise. You have Khaled and last year in China, so there's a satellite experiment, Pavela and AMS 2. So all of this is sensitive to say, well, see, this here, but they don't agree with each other, but then they always say, well, that this year starting to deviate from the expectation. So getting bigger energy, and then there's some excess of positron or electron and the positron together, also a sort of excess. So people still say, well, maybe this can be explained by dark matter. Okay? So at the same time, you can also look for proton interaction. Right, so the proton, so coming in from the outer space, proton or antiproton. Okay, so now if this dark matter is interacting with leptons and proton, quarks, they should also see some sort of excess, similar type of excess. But then you see this here, the theory sort of prediction and all the observations, it seems to be not see that sort of excess. Okay, so now that I think the electrophilic dark matter actually is coming from coming from this type of observation. You have a positron excess, but then you don't see anti-proton excess. So then it seems all the three type of things put together seems to say we don't observe dark matter. Then we may have some sort of dark matter impacted with the electron, which consistent with all observations. You don't have to worry. I don't see the dark matter. Then some maybe it's not there. Right? So secure for. So I then sort of to this point, I hope you believe talk about that prophetic dark matter is a sensible thing to look at, right? Okay, of course, whether this is true, we still have to wait more data to come, more observations to come, to say if this is really true. Well, so, see, in 2009 or so, there's also some sort of this is a phenomena, and then there's an ethical experiment that they even see some sort of a kink here, and then the people, oh, was a very happy about on TV, you have also 900, 800 or something, you have a meter, and then you can do this problem. But then, essentially, now people are not fond about this ethical result. But then, at that time, people producing many types of models to expand this. So, for example, why this dark matter only inhabited with leptons? There are many models. One of the models, for example, in the standard model, it just takes the minimum standard model of particle condensed. Then you say, I want to gauge it. You want a gauge group to gauge the some of the particles. Then you find that in the lepton sector, you have some electron minus muon, or muon minus tau, or tau minus electron. This gauge symmetry is anomaly free, so you don't have to add anything. You just say, well, let's gauge it, and then I have a muon symmetry. U1, and then this U1 gauge particle interacted to the standard model, only interacted with the leptons. Okay? And then if this gauge particle, on the other hand, interact with the dark sector, dark matter, and then this type of model is very easy to produce a prophetic dark matter. Okay? So, then if you do that, they can explain at that time the adequate result. But then, after that, as I said, ethical experiment that people find that things are not quite trustable, many people disregard the results, and then people forget about it, and then continue to do different things. And then, last year, the Dan experiment, they published in Nature some paper, they say this is red, that's okay here, and then they still see some kink here, and then going on here. Well, without the thing here, you can also say, well, maybe I have some dark matter with a certain mass, and then I can expand this excess. But then if you say, well, I really also want to expand this thing here, and then you need a dark matter about 1.4 keV. So if you have that, then you can go easily with this damage experiment. Okay? So now, then, last year, people work on related stuff. Again, get excited about this writing in different nations. And one of them, of course, is the prophetic dark matter. Okay? Now, to do this, then, of course, there are many kinds of models. You can arbitrarily pick up something and then design the dark matter only intact with electrons, or maybe a muon, maybe tau, but we have different things. So, for example, here, so suppose I have a dark matter, which is something like this one. Then I have additional gauge particle. And then the additional particle, that is this X here, you can have the intact. But then if I have the dark matter, for example, dark matter intact with this electron with some sort of scalar particle, and then, of course, you'll have to add up something else to get every constraint works. Okay. But then, many is up here. Well, I think it's several years ago, Spencer and his collaborators have done some calculation. Last year, when the data come out, we used their model, sort of a similar kind of idea to check. So the dark matter, of course, then through this paradigm chain, that go into electron. And then this make it only intact with the electron. And then, of course, here, you call copies F alpha. So maybe you say, well, the electron is big, and then the muon, tau is smaller. Then you can see this picture there. And of course, because of the other particles, you can can all these sense in contribute to the relic density. And then, if you choose, for example, the dark matter 1.4, the data shows that. Then you do this type of calculation, then you say, well, okay, so I can expand the data. Okay? But then, for this type of model, then this here, well, you have to say, well, somehow this electron is bigger than this, then it's arbitrary. And also, in the dark matter, in our galaxy, dark matter halo, some standard model, sort of dark halo, I think yesterday, when Haibo talked about the interacting dark matter, self-interacting dark matter, you have several profile. So if you use that profile here, then why, in sense that the cross-section comes to be right, to be detected by gamble, essentially to be a little arbitrary. So you have to assume maybe you know, that our solar system somehow is bigger than the observable, theoretical sort of dark halo sort of a model. But then this you never know, right? So you have to say, let's say, well, have to do some more type of a check. But then from the theoretical point of view, you say, well, this type of model has two deficits. One is this is arbitrary aside, and something big or something small. And then you want to produce the larger cross section in sense to be, even the people don't do it, say, well, some boost factor of 1,000, several hundred, you know, without any reason, but it didn't just tell you boost factor already made you sort of believe that's true. But then that's some name without a real theoretical basis if you don't have some particular mechanism. So then other type of model, then it's better explained in this sense. So maybe come back to this LI minus LJ type of model. Because as I said, this type of model will fix how the intermediate particle between dark matter and the leptons. So if this is an electron, this is a muon, then the relative strength is fixed. And then you say if your model can expand the data. Clearly, you can see whether you can do it. Okay? And at the same time, because it's a dark matter, for example, it's mediated by this U1 Li minus Lj, then this is S channel sort of annihilation. And then if this dark matter mass, for example, is about half of the Mz, so this part is very small. So that means this, if it's close to the threshold, then this cross section can be very large. How large? It depends on how close this is. So for example, then let's say the mass is very close to the half of the Mz, the dark matter mass is half of the Mz, then this one can be very small and depend on what the velocity is. So this, if it's small, this is small, then this can be very big. For example, if you choose this type of numbers, you can go from here, to here, from here, to so you have some mechanism to driven whatever data requires you, say, suppose it needed this, then you just tune the parameter to here. At least you have something. But then why it's there, then it's not answered. So then they can do it. And then, of course, you calculate the relative density. And then, so relative density, you can do this. And then, for the directed detection, so if you just hit the electron, it's too small. But then this through this loop diagram, you can interact with a proton. And then, but then this will be much smaller than I could hit here directly loop diagram. So, but then this electron is also small. So if you do that, then you'll find that this is the allowed, if you say, well, I fix the relative density here, and then I will get this substitute. So that means this here is allowed. So any here, anything here is consistent with the relic density. Okay? But then, because of this, then you can also say the director search for dark matter maybe not allowed the parameter space. So you do that, then you find that this here, okay, this is from left. Left, then you can do this kind of thing also produce a left, produce a plots. Then you can see some signature. So this here, all that is not allowed. Okay, so now you say, well, direct dark matter search from this type of thing, then you find that here, about that is not allowed. Okay, it's another. So that means that this here is still surviving in the data from them, from the other sort of cosmic ray observation. And then, of course, I tell you later, well, we are still waiting for the IOC to turn on. And then maybe we can go down to here. But let me see at this sort of recent point, that is, this dark matter is almost half of the mediator, zinc prime and particle. And so then this model is very difficult to form a rock. But then, of course, this type of mechanism and to enhance the dark matter may have some other problems with the halo or structure. But then that part is still very model dependent simulation, what type of simulation you have done. So it's very difficult to say, well, that is not enough. So this here, then what I so you can show this here, then my contribution is that leptal dark matter is a viable model. Okay? So from a direction, directed detection of dark matter, you don't see it. It's not because the dark matter is not there. It's because there are many detectors of the leptal. So if you are doing recoil on electron, you can test do better in an experiment. You might verify this. Or you have to do loop level like this here, and then you naturally get a much smaller cross section. Okay? And then for the indirect detection of the cosmic ray, this is very easy to get excess of positron because the analyze through this zinc prime type of thing and only into electron. Or you, if there's a tau, tau can decay and they also still under product is electrons. Okay? So I think that this model is also testable in a sense. So I will go down and then you might close this window. And then this model, whether it's reliable or not, then at the end you can test it. It's not something you cannot really rule out. You know, Pauli has a very famous thing. This model is not even wrong, but at least you can prove this model is wrong. I think I will finish here. I think we will go to the bank on time. On our
very good. Thank you. Finished on time. Very good. Questions? Comments?
Martin? You mentioned it that the leptophilic dark matter are coupled preferably to leptons. So do you know how good are these efforts to look for electron decoy dark matter experiments? Like for light dark matter experiments, it should be very sensitive because they're looking for electron decoys. Can they test the stamp models?
Well, see, you see the directed measurement of the electron
this one.
I think this is kind of a very weak. So. These are the sort of current band. But then later on, they won't be able to go down here. This is experiment. So if you go down to somewhere here, you still don't see that. Maybe you will starting to think about this model might be not correct. Because then these will reach you will reach somewhere here, you still don't see, you're starting to allow it very much.
Okay. Yeah, actually, I want to ask about this parameter signature. So you still have to assume mediator type, Z point type of mediator or something?
Here. Yeah. See, electron, say, for example, lead, for example, then you can produce, then you produce some parts and metals. So you don't say this type of thing, then it's without a problem here. Okay? So, well, if you say, well, let's do it LHC, then it's all this electron signature. And I think it's right now, it's hidden in the hydron background, it's very difficult to see. But then, if you have an IOC turn on, the mass range will be bigger, and then cleaner, you might be able to see something.
In this single, can we see something like a long Trojan tail to like very high energy? We see some kind of tilted, maybe?
Sorry?
For example, you would look at the Trojan tail of a fungi, Trojan process tail from LHC, that it can go to very, very high energy, dialing into an electron pair. Is that possible to get some access here?
Well, in principle, yes, but then still, to see this, of course, that is very small.
Okay.
So you have something, but then maybe the event number is too small.
So I think Martin today say something on Facebook that IOC has been canceled by Japanese.
I didn't say that. I just checked. Don't blame me.
Really? So I don't read the Japanese, so.
I have some Japanese friend can tell us the IOC.
The iPhone can update.
Maybe you can explain better because I don't speak Japanese, so I just share other information.
Okay.
Something
to talk about in the tank, maybe.
Any
other
questions?
I ask Shigeki, he says no.
Oh, okay. So the answer is no. No mean what?
No mean what?
It's delayed, the decision is delayed.
Not canceled.
Not canceled.
Yeah, so it's a fake news. A lot of fake news. Yes,
one
last question.
So, is there any concern from the neutron star pooling? For example, this mediator can be produced by the electron neutrino spectrum and then.
Well, this one does couple to neutrinos. Okay, that's how good neutrinos are. But then this here, because this star is heavy, probably I don't think it won't do much.
Okay, I think that we'll close all the session of the today's, and we are ready for the banquet. And let's thank all the speakers today. Anyone want to have any announcement regarding the banquet?